So, what are we talking about today?
About my favorite problem in geometry when I was a fifth grader. And it is etched in my memory to the point of being able to recall it at any time. So we have three squares of the same sizes next to each other. The size does not matter. And three. So what we will do is pick one of the top corners, let's say the top left corner, and connect it to the bottom right corners of each of those three squares. Next, we will take this angle here at the bottom. Let's call it alpha. The next one at the bottom, let's call it, how do you write beta from that side? Beta. And that's incorrect.
This is because we're doing upside down.
And finally, gamma. All right, so the question is asking, what is the sum of these three angles? So a simple enough problem. The interesting part of it is that it was given to me as a fifth grader. So I had to attack it as a fifth grader. In fifth grade, we learn how to use a protractor. So I measured the first angle. It's about 45 degrees. And in fact, then you can stop and think about it, but of course it has to be 45, since the triangle we are looking at is right in isosceles, this guy here. So that should not be a surprise. You get a 45 degree angle there. And we go about measuring the others, but there perhaps we run a little bit out of luck, because the second angle looks like it's pointing to 25 and a little bit, maybe 26. And the third angle, wow, where is it going? Perhaps 15, 20, so about 18. So when we add this up, 89, could that be it? What do you think?
It seems a bit arbitrary, it doesn't want to know.
Yeah, and also there are all of these mistakes in our measurement. And why would they be asking a fifth grader how much this is and ending up with such a random angle? Well, if you try to make another measurement, perhaps you will come up with 91.3. And so you would say, oh, it's a little bit obtuse, but maybe it's a little bit acute. So what would be a conjecture that people will leap to if they believe this is a beautiful problem?
I would guess that the correct answer, they would think the correct answer is 90.
Exactly, 90. But how would we know really, is it 90 or some ugly angle nearby? We cheat a little bit. We say, okay, that problem was given to a fifth grader. It has got to be a nice answer. We will believe for a moment it's 90, and this is what mathematicians call a conjecture, and then put all of our effort into proving that it is 90. And we are kind of a third of the way to proving it, because we know that one of the angles for sure is 45. So what should be left for the other two angles in order to make 90? Well, obviously 45. So somehow we need to add up the other two angles, beta and gamma, and prove that they add up to 45. Another experiment which a fifth grader might try, and you can also do at home, is cut up the whole thing with scissors and eliminate some of the error that is coming from the protractor when you are rounding the degrees. Okay. So let's try to put everything together, if we can. It does look like this is a 90 degree. Let's check. Yep, it does look like 90 degrees. Okay, so now we truly believe the statement and we want to prove it. Well, the question is, at what level of your mathematical career or mathematical life you are? Because this problem has not only one, not only two, but at least 54 solutions.
54 solutions.
No kidding.
Are we going to do all of them?
No. We will do the most brilliant one, the most simple one that a fifth grader might be able to grasp. So the idea of our solution, at least the attempt when we cut with scissors, can be carried forward mathematically. So we may want to move all three angles into the same geometric location in our picture. So we need to find the best geometric location where to move those three angles. Well, there is no best geometric location until you know what the solution is. So we might as well just try to move them all the way in this corner next to gamma. Because we already have a right angle here, this guy. We have gamma here, and so the other two angles, alpha and beta, must somehow fit. And here comes the brilliant idea of this solution. As I said, there is something missing in this picture. What's missing is half of the picture. We will replicate these three squares up, and then we'll start seeing the truth. And now I think I'm going to start labeling things so people can refer to them later on. I'm just labeling all of the important points. I will choose point H and connect it to two other points, D and E. And I will say that no more constructions will be done in this solution. We somehow have to make sense of what this picture is telling us. Well, for starters, we see three angles exactly where we wanted them to be. Where this 90 degree angle was, we have our original gamma and then two more. Could those two angles be indeed alpha and beta? Well, you can kind of guess that this angle is bigger than the next one by the way it looks. So perhaps that will be the 45 alpha, because alpha was bigger than beta. Could this be 45? And let's try as detectives figure out where it could come from this picture. It is involved in this large triangle. Did we see a similar situation early in the problem? Certainly. Right here, where we saw our original alpha, and where we decided that alpha is 45 degrees, because this was ABE was a right isosceles triangle. Do we have a right isosceles triangle here? We might. Could EH be equal to HD? These are the two extra segments that we draw on top. The answer is yes, because these two segments are hypotenuses, hypotenuse or hypotenuses?
I know what you mean.
So EH and HD, the two segments which we drew, are the hypotenuses of two right triangles, two that we also drew on top. So I'm going to mark them in blue. So these two sides are hypotenuses of two right triangles, EFH and HID, the ones which I drew in blue. Well, they're right because they have a right angle here coming from top, but they are also exactly the same size and shape. This right triangle has one leg 2 and the other leg 1, and this one also has a leg of 2 and leg of 1, which means that their third size, the two hypotenuses, must be the same. So indeed, EH is equal to HD. And we are on our way to show that this big green triangle in the middle is right isosceles. It's already isosceles. Question is, why is this guy right? Okay, but what else is around this angle? There is this guy here, this angle, and this other one. What do they add up to? And the answer is also very simple. One of those angles we already know. I claim that this angle is our angle beta. Because there is a third triangle which is precisely the same shape and size as those. It is right here. Again, a right triangle with legs 1 and 2. And so therefore this angle beta must be equal to this angle beta, and guess what? It must be equal to this angle beta. They all share exactly the same angle. So accidentally, we have shown that we have moved angle beta to where we wanted it. Gamma is there, and if that is really 45, we will be done. And again, backtracking, we wanted to show that this big triangle was right isosceles. We already know that this angle here is beta. What is this guy? Well, this guy, this second angle, participates in a right triangle where the other acute angle is beta. What could this guy be? We know that the angles in a triangle add up to 180. This guy is 90. Therefore, these two must add up to 90. Simple arithmetic shows that this angle here must be 90 minus beta. 90 minus beta, something, and beta must overall give you 180. What is the remaining angle here? This curly one. If you start adding up, let's do it. Beta plus 90 minus beta plus something must be 180. So beta goes away, and that something turns out to be our 90 degrees.
You've done it.
That's right. So our angle alpha is indeed moved here along with beta, and we can conclude that the three angles add up to 90 degrees. And this is an amazing construction which uses only squares, isosceles triangles, and congruent right triangles with legs 1 and 2. And that is indeed a brilliant approach which mathematicians take to solve problems. They complete it to what's missing there. And then the problem becomes Greenland, or enough gasoline in Greenland to add up to 2. Mathematicians may find that question a bit too hard.